hard work.
This isn't going to be easy.
This is Birmingham, right? You know what I'm saying? Ham on the act?
Birmingham.
I said it wrong earlier, and I felt like such a fool.
I think this is our seventh show of this tour. And I will say thank you. Thank you for the support. You've been working hard. I will say this. You guys have the opportunity to be our best audience yet. Award for a whitest
audience.
Hey, buddy, did everybody enjoy the new season of Practical Jokers? And you saw the episode of Monday Night that we filmed in London? you know, back in New York, we're filming the new season that'll be on here in a little bit. And as you can see, my eyebrows grew back just in time! It took 2 months for my eyebrows to grow back. 2 months!
I don't know why you don't get them. They didn't do it to you. We did. If you guys don't know what we're talking about, the four of us, we make this TV show, right? And James lost an episode, so we decided to shave his eyebrows, send it to the Department of Motor Vehicles to make him get a new driver's license photo. Picture here.
No, he looks like he's had a banana vagina. You look like Lex Luthor's penis.
You look like a ping pong ball going through a divorce.
Let me get one. You look like a racist peach.
Yeah.
You look like a thumb that voted for Donald Trump. I got another one. You look like when you move into a neighborhood, you have to tell the cops exactly where you live. You look like a pencil eraser with Crohn's disease. Wait, you look like the character from every time travel movie that runs up to the main character and goes, "Listen to me, there's not enough time."
I mean, I can get over the picture and all, but what's this about, friends? Organ donor? Who's gonna take an organ from that thing? I'm just gonna die. Thanks so much.
He looks like an organ collector. Yeah, that face is the last thing you see before you wake up in a tub full of ice when you're kidding. I'll tell you what, we have the black heart on.
Yeah, what's with the double chin on?
Yeah, you only got two ketchup, baby. I'm up to six.
You know, we'll take credit for shaving your eyebrows off.
That looks terrible.
But the face that you're making in that photo. That's your own fault.
I mean, you're smart. When you have no eyebrows, people don't know what expression you have on your face. I am smiling! We may not realize that when we throw punishments, we have no idea what's going to happen to us that day, right? So that night, I had normal plans set up, not realizing that I had someone's eyebrows. Right? That night, I had a date set up. It did not go well. Will Martin get laid? Two weeks later, I was my nephew's confirmation sponsor in church, so I had to stand in front of a church full of 500 people proclaiming that I would defend my nephew against Satan while looking like Satan!
The priest walked into the church and was like, Alleluia.
Alleluia.
Shaved his eyebrows. We went to London to shoot that episode that you guys saw last week. While we were there, we're like, this is too good. We cannot waste this opportunity. We have to shoot something just for everybody that comes to our live show. So here's what we did. We drew eyebrows on Murray. Various different emotions. And we said, whatever emotion you just draw on your face, stay on it. Go out there and interact with people in London. Ladies and gentlemen, the Timberlands are very proud to present a boy in his eyebrows. Check this out.
Just give me a photo of you, if you don't mind. Thank you so much, appreciate it. No. No, man, it's a photo of shit. Can you take it one time, please? We'll try to frame it just a little better, okay? Thank you so much. Shift over a little. There you go.
So I go to the bathroom and see what she's talking about, and there's just a floater in the bowl. There's a turd in the turlet. Okay?
That sounds like a classic fairy tale.
Story of the turd in the turlet. It's great. Mom, I can't sleep. Fine, get under the covers. Mommy will read you the story of the turd in the turlet.
I'm actually working on writing that sound. Like a good fairy tale for you people. It's about a beautiful princess who kisses a turd. I didn't think it through. I didn't think it through, alright? I said it, I saw it talking about fighting. It was
a work in progress.
I'll get that.
So now, I'm trying to figure this out, right? I didn't put it in, okay? James is at work. There's only one suspect left in this turd of mystery. And it's not Pop. So I go to talk to her because I have follow-up questions and she's gone. Right? So now it's just Joe the turd and the turlets.
Oh, that's gonna be my sequel.
Episode number two.
Yeah, there you go.
Right? So I guess she wants me to believe that this turd magically worked its way up 19 stories to the 19th floor where we live by coming up through the pipes instead of just dropping out of her one pipe. I wasn't buying one, I had to take care of it, so I grabbed the plunger and I was just thinking, listen, I have to do it. Finally it goes down, I pull the plunger out. And the tiniest piece of turd, the dot com, comes flying through the air and lands on my bare big toe. Oh. Yeah, I know, I was there, man. I don't know if you know what happens to an adult man when a piece of human shit falls on his foot. It's not from it, nor comes from someone he loves, but he flips the fuck out.
What the hell does that mean?
Anybody that you love gonna shit on your foot? My friend's 27 years, double weight money. This bitch, no way, no how.
So, can I shit on your foot?
I'll get back to you. No.
when it comes to our friendship, Mark, you come in third.
Oh, yeah.
I'll have you here all night. Nice
really? Really? I think I'm the shit.
I like it. Can you keep moving? He's on piece of shit.
That's what? Wait.
Right, so I'm sitting there with a piece of a turd on me. I don't know what to do. I turn into like a shit penguin. Like I was riding on the fall of the foot, so I'm like waddling around, right? Because if it comes off, it's my responsibility to find it. That's on me. I gotta stop playing hard. Go turn, go seek. I'll turn. Marco, turn on. It's not a fun game.
Marco,
turn on.
Marco,
turn on. She don't know what to play. So I grab a marker and I waddle over to Murray's bedroom door. And I write calm on it. And I smack the dot right in front.
Funny little left back the story on dot com and I are still dating. She's right there on the baby. It's not you, this story.
You're a weirdo. You're a weird fella. Say why the only thing you was your roommate, not me, if it was me, I would just beat you to death the second you walked in. Turn foot when I went straight down the throat.
Yeah, because you like violence for the most part.
Oh, God, I love violence. It's the only way to get erection with violence is AIDS. Sorry,
trust me. I know.
It's getting out of control. There's a doctor in the audience. I'd love to talk to him for 10 minutes.
10 minutes.
So, that real quick. He needs you in 10 minutes at least.
No, I'm not going to unravel this fucking problem in a second. But listen. Violence I don't like is violence towards animals. I don't like that. I don't like hunting. I don't see how you can go into it. Yeah, I'm taking a firm stance at the hunting right now. I'm gonna shoot some. I saw that Disney movie with the deer and he shot his mom in the face.
Bambi?
I don't know what.
Bambi, it's a movie. It's an animated film by Walt Disney. It's not a documentary, but it's
real. Looks real to me.
No, you need to just relax, okay?
It's a movie. Everyone knows it.
A whole new thing! It's Disney.
Is it not?
No.
I don't watch Disney. I'm sorry.
Oh my God, I'm so embarrassed.
That's from Aladdin. That's from Aladdin.
I saw that. That was a documentary about the Middle East.
That's right. What is it?
Wait. I don't watch Disney, but which one is Bambi?
What song's from Bambi?
Under the Sea.
Under the Sea.
That's a little mermaid.
You're an idiot.
You know?
Again,
very bad.
Just move on.
My family is a bunch of hunters, though.
Nah, say what? Nah, I'm gonna meet you.
What the hell are you people caring about? I just said two smashed solid gold ones. I got fucking nothing.
That's not a real song anyway. It's not a track from the CD.
It is too much.
That's one of the best ones from the Lion King.
It's a blur from the movie.
Yeah, oh, yeah, those are both the real words too? I don't think so.
To me, not racist at all.
Exactly. Elton John might as well be up here
singing. That's what I imagine you do, Joe, when you bring home yet another dollar to our family.
Yeah.
You presented like Rafiki.
Yeah, they come in. I said, I got the cattle pucks and whole pack at home now. I walk home like, hey, honey.
The other one's like, ooh. The second
one. That's my pups. The cattle pucks, I love them. A gorgeous pack of dogs. Rescued on the river.
Gorgeous? You want to see Joe's newest gorgeous dog, Machine?
Machine's the boy.
That's not Mufasa, that's Mufugly.
Listen, his breed is on the inside, but he's still beautiful. 12 years old, has no teeth, we don't give a fuck.
Guys, this is what happens when you buy a dog off Groupon.
Dude, I love you, but it looks like Joe went to the pet store and was like, yeah, do you have something with all the diseases?
Yeah, it was buy one disease, get them all free. So I got a biscuit.
The dog looks freshly electrocuted.
It's his hands, that's what he wears in his pump.
It looks like you pulled it right out of the dryer.
He likes to be fresh. He's got the thumb hanging out, he's ready to party. You know, he's out there like one of those party blows. He's like, let's do it.
Why is his tongue sticking out that far? That was weird.
Because you don't pay attention when I talk, okay? He's got no teeth, so the tongue pops right out. There's nothing holding it back. It's a riddle without a game.
That's not how tongues work.
That's a real tongue.
Don't mind you know. That's not how tongues work. If I didn't have all my teeth, my tongue would be swinging out around my nipples.
I'm talking bad about my dog, which you're not going to
Joe needs to tell his dog that the dog has an abnormality. He's lying to his dog. I'm being honest with the dog.
I'm shooting your dog straight. You're being an enabler. He's walking around to the other dog and says, this is normal.
The thing that strikes me is two things. One, we live in a... We live in an age. Owen Benjamin got me so fucking drunk. Sorry. We live in an age of
control.
Well, I drank an awful lot.
So, yeah.
This is the two things. Like, we live in the age of digital photography. You can, every bad photo you delete, which means one thing. This is the best photo we can find in this fourth book.
Yeah, it's his Facebook profile picture.
Shit all over his face. Like, he looks like a
Is he on
Tinder? Does he get a lot of attention? Is that like a serious, just huge blade just chilling right on his face?
Now it's a piece of food. This is not the tongue, so he just puts his face in a ball and hopes for the best.
Why don't we wipe them? Kind of like you do.
We need the same.
If this is going out of here, the voice would sound just like this.
He didn't smoke cigarettes.
That's him barking. The giant, you're poop off. Oh. Oh, I'm gonna poo poo on you.
That's fine, buddy. You can do it. I know you.
What are you looking at me for? I'm the one who's allowed to shit on you. You hear the voice? You hear that voice you just did? See how annoying that was? Still not as annoying as that com. I swear to God.
He's a joke, baby. He's joking with you.
Why do you keep pointing at the guy in the green t-shirt?
Well.com is going through a transition.
Yeah, it's just becoming a .org.
Yes. So, alright, hunting, right? So my family's a bunch of hunters. My cousin Gino specifically is a big hunter. He's older than me. He was 18 and I was 12. He was always like, how about we go hunting? That's how he spoke. How about we go hunting? What's the matter with you? You don't like the hunt? I'm Italian. Talk to
them. Pasco Mazzullo, eh? Pepperoni, yes. Hey, pepperoni.
He just named Italian food. Was he reading off an Italian restaurant's menu?
Italian, speak Italian.
Yeah, he knows. Pizza.
That's what you got.
Right,
yeah?
Yeah, he knows. More pizza. I don't know if that still is working out for you, buddy. Nah, I'm so sure I'm going to go on. I went to Kalana, so I was like, no, so finally he was like, all right, how about this? We'll go to the woods, we'll shoot some trees, no killing animals. This 12-year-old brain put out in for. I get dressed up in camouflage, I get my face painted, we're going to go.
Why? You already said you weren't going to hunt anything, so what exactly are you hiding from? The other trees? You're afraid you're going to walk into the woods and the trees and be like, ooh.
Don't move a branch.
Now, you're making fun of me. He wore leather Cabezio shoes, pleated slacks, a knife beater t-shirt, gold herringbone chain, pinky ring. That's how he goes up there. So I look good. I was having a good day though. Great day. Shoot trees left to right. Walking through the woods. I come to a clearing and I see something beautiful. Something mystical in its beauty. A bird. The most beautiful bird you'll ever see in your entire life. Man, this was amazing. Like the plumage and the tail. This bird had a great ass. It was just there, and looking at me with like these intelligent eyes. And it was singing a song. It spoke to my heart from love with the bird. I turned to my cousin Gino to share this special moment with him. And Gino has his gun pointed at the bird. My bird. So I did the only thing that anybody here would do, of course. I shot my cousin Gino. I nailed him. You are an insane person. That's not even close to the only thing you could have done.
Yes, you have so many options. Take your gun, shoot in the air, scare the bird away. Rock, throw it, scare the bird away.
You could have been like, Gino. No.
Any sound you would have made would have scared the bird away. You could have just clapped like.
No, nobody wants to hear what little bird has to say.
We have a stroke. what it says?
Penicillin.
Stop eating me.
Is it always dark? I'm always alone. So
stop making fun of yourself.
Soloalone.com. So I shot Gino. And this is the end of my day. I'm not having fun anymore. Now I gotta lug this fat, bleeding, cursing mama Luke back home to my aunt's house.
Dude, I love you. You're my best friend, but I have to shoot you straight. You sound horrible right now.
No. You're complaining about the relative that you gunned down to save a sparrow.
Like, you're a criminal. That's a felony. You shot your own fresh flesh and blood. You're like, oh my god, I shoot my cousin. I gotta hear this all day in the woods. He's like, hey, Italian food.
That's what I'm gonna shoot.
I don't want to be part of
it.
It was horrible. I imagine the holidays are awkward, right? You go over to Gino's family's house for the holidays. It's like a nice big turkey on the table. A bowl of scoops, even top as you're ready. You walk in the house, you got like a pot's can. Gino pops up and says, oh, Brian, don't shoot. This bird was dead when I got here, I swear to God.
That would be the case if I got invited to family parties. I don't anymore. My aunt to this day still will not talk to me. Whole family calls me shooting again, right? But I'll tell you why, Marianne, or however the fuck to say it. I saved that bird's life.
You did?
That's all that matters in this scenario. Yeah, he's out there right now. Six bird seeds out the time of his life. My bird!
It's a 30-year-old bird.
Yes!
That bird got eaten by a hawk about 12 seconds later.
That bird is dead.
Dude, I can't believe you shot him.
I think he was 12. I think he was 12. He was shot.
You're okay with that?
I have a flu.
You're right on it? No, please shoot. I'm just going to shoot me. Anyway, the first time I ever saw a little gun in front of my face, I was 30, and a little pee came out, because if I'm being honest,
and that's nerve-wracking.
I know it's shocking.
start shouting. It sounds normally such a strong rock of a man. And his hands shake.
Joke all you want, man. I was 30 years old. I used to live in this little basement studio apartment. And one day I passed out, pitch black, sound asleep. And I hear a pounding at the front door. A pounding. It's like, boom, boom, boom.
Joe.
She gets around. It was not her. I would shoot her on sight. Now, I didn't know what it was. I jumped up, right? I'm going to shovel it. Hello? And I hear from the front door. Sal! Dan! Hurry up! Open the door! Dan was my upstairs landlord. He was a big Irish dude. He was a New York City detective. Right? Yeah, Irish detective. What have you got? So, so I jump up, and I fumble to the door, and I pitch black, and crack open. And some comes in, and I go, what's up? He goes, did you hear anything? I was like, no. Dan, what are you talking about? He goes, I just got home. My door upstairs is off the hinges. Somebody broke into my home. I think it is still in there. Let's go. He says, let's go. I'm up 10 seconds. I'm fresh out of a run size. I got trouble in my face. I'm in Heineken pajamas. I'm not ready for this kind of responsibility, but I don't have my wits about me. So it's like, let's.
You grab your cardigan before you send that song.
I grab my bathrobe. That's how I do it. He's a New York City cop. You have a finance degree. What exactly was your role?
I should have crunched up numbers and realized it was a bad investment. Thank you for looking at me. But I wasn't thinking. I mean, get to the front of the house, the door. His door is off the hinges.
Holy cow. And then he goes and pulls his loaded gun out of his the cop shop thing that they do.
What?
I don't watch those games. I'm not a cop.
What's a cop strap?
The freaking thing, the leather attaché that they do to holsters. Grab yourself. Fine. He pulls his holster out of his cuff.
Better.
They put you in the dick, graduated the police academy.
They were like, congratulations, officer. Here's your cop strap.
Here's your shooting movie. There's your badge of wasted. Hell not bad.
Yeah, he was like, I'm gonna get the bad guy.
We're making a joke. No, literally, he's like, he pulls the gun out, right? And he goes, I'm gonna go in south. I'm gonna go in and secure the perimeter. You get my back. And I said to him, I'm your guy. I'm your guy, I said to him. To this day, I don't know why he said that. I'm not his guy. I'm nobody's guy.
You're barely a guy.
Barely a guy. So we go to the house. And as soon as we get to the front door, it's like something I've only seen in movies, right? He's like, swimming both ways, you know? Like you in college, I'm just kidding. I say that joke every show. I'm pointing in this direction. If you thought it was about you, it's your fault.
So I can't believe how calm you are in the situation. Knowing you, I would have thought you would have been freaking out.
I'll retell you that bit later. In the moment, I tried to maintain, but inside, I was full of opinions. I was like, no, hell no, he didn't just pull the shooting movie out of his top trap. It's going to be crazy now. I became a black woman.
I was like, Tommy Joyce got that nuts, y'all.
They don't know what a black woman is.
Yeah. Look, Google it, guys. It's great.
Oh my God, it's so
like, yeah, I'm going to give it that one.
Right. You're just tan.
Help me. You have a lot of foundation.
Spray tan's on the side.
So anyway, so he clears the whole first floor. There's nobody down there. And like, but don't give up yet because we have upstairs, right? And so we have to go upstairs. And I'm making light of this, guys, but this is really intense. Put yourself in my shoes. He's got a loaded gun on his regular spot. He's trying to make it creak and steps. He's got a face stone on. And I'm right behind him. Time to get your eyes. You know what he's done. I think at one point it's hitting me, I didn't think this would be.
This week on Scooby-Doo.
He's got a handgun, you have a gun to me.
You know what we should have done, Sal? The hand in the pants thing, like when they rob a bank in the movies.
That would have been there. Yeah, somewhat back. You're like, believe this. I'm more moved than you. This goes off.
That wobble up to that moment, you would have been like, dude, that really would have been there. If this guy jacked it off and hiding it.
Oh! You try and steal dancing these ice in your wings. Stop doing that with the screen. Turn to something else.
Is anybody else get really turned on right now?
I'm sorry, don't leave. So we get to the top of the steps. There's one door upstairs. This is so weird. There's one door upstairs, which means this, guys. If anything is happening, it's happening now behind this door. So I'm firmly on this. And he turns to me and he starts to whisper. He goes, look at me. And I was like,
becomes an empty shell of a man, caught in the shadows of his own thoughts.
people in the morning.
Hugh looks like he lives in a van down by the river.
Very funny.
You look like Jesus' face showed up in a cheese pizza.
you look like Rosie O'Donnell back at the Sasquatch.
I know somebody goes to supermarkets and asks them, he begs them for the dented cans.
You look like Teen Wolf turned 40 and got fat.
You literally look like the woman from The Ring. Oof, yes.
You look like someone left Jack Black in the microwave.
you don't look good, that's what we're saying. You don't look good.
We love you, bud.
These are my best friends, ladies and gentlemen. You look like you hold my feet up to the lights.
Can I wear a butt?
Please do.
You want me?
Get your butt up.
This is going to be difficult to do because I'm so hungover. So I'm going to need help from you, sir. That's me wearing makeup at 6 a.m. on a Tuesday. When was the last time you wore, pretty ladies' makeup? Probably why, right? Probably never, because you're a manly man. That's me, buddy. That's me. You know what I was before this TV show? True story. New York City firefighter. 8 years with the FDNY. Yeah. Real manly shit. I ran into burning buildings, all right? That's me wearing makeup at 6:20 a.m. on a Tuesday. And I know you guys in the firehouse are watching. And I know they're going to call me the second I'm off that stage. And they're going to be like, ooh, princess. You look so pretty on TV today, young little actress. A little actress, they call me actress. Me actress! Who the whole first season of Practical Jokers, another true story. And we would shoot during the day, at night I would go to the firehouse, work all night, come back to set the next day, come in soot, smelling like smoke from, say, like, kitten in a tree.
One.
The tree was on fire! That's how we got! You understand what I'm saying? And I handled it! Alright, I don't deserve this.
I love you, but you sound crazy again.
Listen to me.
Advice on your front.
Okay.
You should take a little less time worrying about sparrows and kittens. And more time worrying about the woman from the ring.
So wait a second. Because I'm not going to go that. Mark, call up and make it. Call up Sal. And I say this with love in my heart. Marry who you want to marry. All one love. Everyone is right to equal. I mean that. Take this the right way when I say that you look like a homosexual Pee Wee Herman impersonator. Right there.
Sal looks like a Stepford husband.
You look like you're about to break the truth to your dad about you and your roommate Gary.
You think I look like a feminine?
You just stood up here and was like, my fire hat friends called me an actress!
It's not so much what Sal looks like. I get it. I love him. He looks great. He's got his pink lips going on. They were oddly pink. I don't know why, but it's the way you're presenting yourself and what you're discussing with her. It doesn't match. It looks like he's talking to her about like a bank loan. He's like, yeah, 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 I'm not looking at 2.7%. It's good. 2.8% is under the right. Let's go APRs and all the fair work. Let's do it, baby.
Okay, look at you.
Knock, knock. Who's there?
God, fuck on the ends.
Caribbean Ocean in high tide.
He looks like a beached blue whale.
He looks like all of Walter White's men.
I look like Papa Smurf got stung by a bee.
If I look like Jack Black, you look like Steve Carell ate Steve Carell.
You know what your issue is, buddy? I'm a level with you here in front of our 13,000, 14,000 parts.
You still shop for designer clothes.
Now, his designer shirt ship sailed a long time ago. Because they don't fit him the right way. Like, he goes in on these banquet, he gets these Armani Exchange, Hugo Boss shirts. It's not for you. You know how much they do? First button great, second button great, every other button big button problem. It's like boom, boom, boom.
He goes, okay, takes the phone. That was my mother.
He took the phone.
Oof, that is some white people bullshit. Let me explain that to you guys. The United States of America is racial tension. Cops don't always treat everybody the same. You guys don't have that problem because everybody's the fucking same.
In a good way.
We have a bad thing going on sometimes. I love that cop's like, all right, I'll do you one favor, poopoo baby.
Poopy baby, not poopoo baby.
I'll do you.
Easy shit kid.
See, that was a phone call.
Shit kid.
That was a phone call. My phone gets up on speed. She's like, Poopy baby, how was it here? He's like, man, this is all the swords you put the gun stay, please. She's like, where's my son? Man, I'm trying to explain to you, he doesn't, I'm an officer of the law. And she goes, how do I know that? He goes, because I just told you. She goes, yeah, like I'm supposed to believe you. So like, bam, your son doesn't have his license. She goes, okay, his name is Joseph. He's got black hair, dreamy blue eyes. He's driving my white Mercedes. Put him on the phone. Thank you. The officer just points out enough. He was listening to the phone. So, dude, your mom wants to talk to you. So, I sat there, victorious. And I was like,
you said that. You said,
no. Oh, I would have, but my hand, I was like, I did it different because I was seated. My hands were like at the 10-2, and I was like, I did it quick, but it wasn't looking like suck.
We used to take road trips together all the time. Believe it or not, we've known each other so long, we actually used to ride bicycles together when we were 13 years old. And we were recently romantic, and we don't really do that anymore. So over the summer, we decided to rent a couple bicycles and go to the park and skid off to strangers, but do what we do now on the show, which is make it as awkward as possible. If you see her, tell her I'm looking for her. Sup, versions.
Anyway. So. Anyway.
Dead bed, dickweeds.
The guy in a bike with a badass skin.
I want to kiss your sister.
I've never seen someone skid straight before.
What are you talking about? We're supposed to skid, not come to a decent club. Fine.
You don't jiggle.
He's gone.
Good job, Lizzie Bones.
Oh!
Okay, cool. Lovely there. What's your gender? What's your...
I just blasted through my briefs. Thinking is that I fought it with such force that I shot right through my tiger-wagus. I love you, let me know.
He's covered his ass.
I don't know if you heard I blasted through my briefs.
Yeah, I get that social mic.
We did great on bikes. Instead of doing cars.
Well, yeah.
Because cars had a terrible road rage. Like, you guys, now I get it the worst. Like, I pulled the road rage.
Anybody here got this road rage?
Oh my god, like 90% of you have liars.
Or don't drive.
The worst case of road rage I ever got was so embarrassing to me. I think I can tell the story right now. My car got totaled. I didn't know what I was going to do. I was nervous. How did I get to work? I'm working on bills. And I was desperate. So I went on Facebook. And I'm like, friends, my car got totaled. I don't know what I'm going to do. Does anyone have a car tomorrow? Please, I'll pay you. I was like, begging. I didn't know that was going to work. But it turned out a lot of people have extra cars. I couldn't believe it. My friend Carol wanted, she don't get a car. She wanted $300. Which is a lot of money. I don't know. So I thought I was going to be screwed. So my friend Joe Fortieri said, hey buddy, you got $30. And I was like, well, I got that. He's like, come to my house. And I ended up using his car. It's the type of car that people keep on their lawn outside. The whole thing was full of my car, really. Like the interior ceiling, the cloth fell down. And he packed it back out. Like that was normal. Like the inside of the car looked like a gal oven.
You couldn't even talk to your passenger. I'm like, dude, I'm supposed to be your
passenger.
This is what I'm driving around with, right? And one day, this guy in the car cut me off in traffic, and I slammed on the brakes. And we missed getting to an accident by that much, that close. And I'm very shaken up by it. And when I pulled up to the red light, they pulled beside me. And he immediately goes, hey, bud, roll down your window. I'm like, here we go. So I lunge. And I already told you guys I got the range. And I already told you this wasn't my car. He leads off with, watch where you're going. I said, are you kidding me? You cut me off. I didn't have the price to recognize that it's your fault. He goes, shut up. My car's a piece of shit. Well, I get very irrational. I get the range. And I get demonic. And I start telling them details they don't even need to know. I'm like, piece of shit. My car got totaled by a Filipino teen 6 days ago. This isn't my piece of shit. My piece of shit got totaled. I didn't know what I was going to do. So I went on Facebook and I begged. And I begged some more. And a girl said she wanted $300. Fuck you and your family, Carol. I thought I was going to be screwed until Joe Frontieri said you have $30, and I got that. The point is, this is Joe Frontieri's piece of shit. It was a world. And then she knows me and goes, oh my god, you're from Practical Jokers. And I was like, yes. And then he leaned over and goes, yeah? Shows a piece of shit. The rage. I said, no, it's not a piece of shit. The world is going to shit in this day and age when everything's messed up and everybody hates each other and no one is on anyone's side. Our show provides some laughs, and I think that's invaluable in this day and age. And the point is, me and my friends are trying our best.
I drove away 1 minute before I said that. Fuck, you couldn't see it. The drapes were in the way.
The point is, I stuck up for us. I might be irrational, but I stuck up for us.
Very proud.
You're right. I don't subscribe.
I handle the rage a little bit differently. With Sal, likes to use his words on more of an action.
You see, when it comes to the rage,
action, action.
I used to drive a 1994 Plymouth Blazer, which, if you know anything about cars, you'll know it's a chick's car.
Yeah, it's like, you guys probably know that. It's one of those cars where you see a guy driving it. It's like, I can see the bar of his girlfriend's car.
Oh, yes. Yes, it is. That's Q's car.
With the gold rims on.
I used to drive this on Staten Island, which, on Staten Island, if you're driving a chick's car, basically every weirdo in the world will tell you it's just to start a fight. So it's always very defensive when I was driving this car. I was always halfway into what Sal calls the range. Now, on this particular day, though, I was in a very good mood. Why? I'm glad to ask. Thank you for asking that important question. Because it was Baconator season in the United States, which is a miserable.
Oh, they're Wendy's here?
Wendy's is the best version. It's like McDonald's. So, Wendy's, they have a sandwich called a Baconator. It only comes out, who's been here to America? Been to America? You've never been to America? So you've had a Baconator. You went to Wendy's and had a Baconator. Are you lying to me, or did you? Which was it, buddy? You didn't go to Wendy's. It's disrespectful bullshit. You go to the United States, my United States of America. You don't go to Wendy's and get a baby. Were you wasting your life? You disgust me. I just see the Statue of Liberty.
As a matter of fact, I did. It was beautiful.
You what? Wait, how old are you? 25? Oh, fuck you!
You're 25 American, or is there a conversion?
You go to the United States and you don't even bother trying to have fine food. That is weak, dude. The food you have here is shit. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, porridge. Oh, fuck you, porridge. Please, sir, can I have someone? No! No, you're gonna have a pig eater, bro. And say, don't give me the finger. I know what to do here. I don't know why I'm gonna fight with the audience.
You were talking to Sal earlier about it, and now you're attacking him.
So it's because of the rage. So look, man. Alright, look, look, you gotta get one. It's 980 calories, right? Two all beef, never frozen patties. Cheese in between, cheese on top, and on top of that cheese, bacon, baby. More bacon than you know what to do with, honey. You would even say it's like Jesus. And Dan Thomas, founder of Wendy's. His family's right there. Yeah. He had sex, and now came the Baconator. And they're sitting there looking at him, what don't we look at?
Take it easy.
Can I go do something? Do something. Do something.
Your money to the pound.
your suit. Stop making fun of yourself again. Everyone else is making fun of me.
Oh, stop it.
That's a ghost. In all honesty, it is a decent sandwich at a reasonable price.
They're not warm, baby. So is bacon and cheese. So I was in a good mood. So I pull up to the Wendy's drive-thru. I get two baconators and an unsweet nice thing. Ready to do it.
How'd you get two baconators, you big fat fuck, did you? Couldn't get the one. Had to double down on it. Because you needed 1,960 calories of four never frozen whole beef patties, eight slices of cheese, and more bacon than your body knew what to do with.
I say I got the sweet, nice teeth because I'm trying to lose some LBs, you know?
Pretty sure you don't know how losing LBs works if you double down on it. Look at me, you got fries too, didn't you?
Hey, take it easy. The fries were on the sweet.
You're right, let's not fight about it. High fries. Friends, high fives. Let's not even worry about it.
Oh my god, you guys have to stop.
Listen to me. Don't even worry about it, buddy. You get out.
You get out. You get out.
You get out.
You get out.
It's not Fox versus
you.
It's Fox versus
you.
What
are you doing? Is he
on? Comedy 101. You would have walked up and pulled that back. This place would have done the Mexican wave. Which is very racist, and it's amazing because you don't have black people.
Also, for you know for a fact, I always have your backs.
All of them. Your upper back, your fat back, your side back, all backs.
He's bringing sexy backs!
Yeah?
This whole audience is awing, like it's a telephone up here.
Sorry. We're friends, we planned this. We're making fun of each other for you.
I don't remember. The bar's over here. Speed up. I can't remember the next fucking line. Where were we?
Well, we just did the high five bit.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then did the sexy back thing.
Yeah.
Cute. Well, here's the difference between me and you. I'm a man of words, and you're a man of action.
Got it. Okay, so. I'm so hungover. Alright, listen. So I pull out of the Wendy's drive-thru, right? And I pull out the Highland Boulevard, which is the main drag there. I come to a red light. This guy pulls up next to me. What did I tell you about Staten Island? He just walked up to my car and goes, nice car, Mary. Now, my name is not there, it's not. Which means he's only making fun of my car. And this is where I get.
To a bridge, I'm sorry.
Come on, buddy.
I was looking at the big screen.
Can we do it again?
That's right. I'll nail this one.
Okay. Stay in front of my car. So this is what happens. This is where I get the rage.
Hey, that's how I'm going to talk to my daddy.
That is.
Sal, I'm a puppeteer. Let's do this.
Look, he's got a gun on me.
Let's cut that.
All right. Let's cut the fisting joke from the next set. So here we are.
We've never done that before.
This is all for you! It's a great time to try out a brand new joke about 15,000 people who are trying to fist
me. We're not going to do this backstage!
Like, speed up, this will sell merch!
Speed up, you're going to get that fisting joke! Asshole just spoke me, right? That's where we're at in the story. So where Sal starts yelling at the guy, I take my sweet nice knee, I throw it out the window off my car towards him. Didn't intend this, but hey, it was a great day. It went in the window, it hit the headrest, and exploded all over the interior of this judgmental prick's car. It was, oh yeah.
It was like an unsweet nice tea for me.
It was like a thing that you Google it. So cute.
You realize you threw the only thing out of the car that had no calories, Jones.
Yeah, hey, two baconators. Throw out one of the baconators. Stunned on me.
What?
Get out. Two baconators.
You can't even knock the mic stand over. You're too busy fisting your body trying to knock the mic stand over.
Hello, Dad?
Let's talk about Gary.
So here we are. Think of the situation. I'm shocked. I didn't mean to assault a
guitar, from his steering wheel, from his face, from his mustache. I'm sitting there like, hey, mustache. You know. But this guy's choice on size, he can kick my ass, and the light's still red. I'm stuck in situation with him. You understand what I'm saying? I don't know what's about to happen. Is he about to kick my ass? I don't know. So I hit the gas. Run the red light, my car starts skidding out all across the sidewalk. People
on the sidewalk like, look at that crazy bitch drive!
Oh yeah. No brakes, remember? So now, I just assaulted another human being who could kick my ass. I just ran a red light. He followed me, or the cops chasing me. I don't know. So I panic, come to another red light, run that one too. Now I'm really fucked. Like, now I'm really about to die. I'm freaking out, I'm panicking. I'm gonna get arrested in my ass beat. So I'm panic, panic, panic. I pick up my cell phone and I call Sal.
That's an odd choice.
Yeah. I'm sitting at home half asleep in my Heineken pajamas. As per usual. I pick up the phone and all I hear is love. I hear, sounds cute! I'm being pursued! I'm being pursued! And you and I know pursued is not a word. he doesn't know that. He's like, I'm being trivially pursued! No joke, I can understand every 10th word he was saying. Like, I didn't even, it couldn't piece it together. He's like, sounds cute!
All right, so
Listen to me, they don't know what I mean anyway.
Kids, Google it.
Do not Google it.
Hey, Google listens.
Do not Google it.
Black fist.
Don't Google it. Kids, do not.
You don't know the black fist.
Google lemonparty.org. Don't do that.
No!
Murray, the last person on my call if I need to bury a body in a desert is the lunatic who stands in front of all those people and talks about how he'll bury the body. That's just stupid.
It is weird. Like, I don't even know you. Like, I've known you for 27 years, but I don't know what you do when you're alone.
I feel like you.
I feel like when he's home alone, he sits with the lungs like empty. No radio, no TV on. He's in like a silk robe, just waiting for the phone to ring.
Transistor radio.
What? Come and ask me. Sometimes, what if I was in robes with you?
I feel like it's petroleum.
Let me see that. Let me pull one real quick. Ring, 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 ring.
Hello, it's Mark.
What can I do? What? I'm sorry that I accidentally called Gollum from Lord of the Rings.
Thank you.
Maybe, just maybe, we'll be back.
back in October for a brand new show.
Let's listen to the new show.
Hey, we want to do something very cool right now. You see us post these photos online, you can see that you're all in the photo. We want everybody to stand up, hands up in the air, the whole stadium, hands up in the air. Everybody's in, all the spots are in. We're even posting us. We want you to speed our photo.
This is going up on a frame on our wall, please.
You ready? Control that spotlight right there. There
we go. Come on, hands up. On three. Here we go.
We love you. And as a thank you gift, we have this very nice present for you. This is from season one of the Summer Poppies at Poppy Sandy. We're down in the basement waiting for them to be ready for us. I'm going to push me over there. Grabs a can of dog food. He says, who do you think for 20 bucks? My man Marty says, I'll do it. Sal says, okay, Marty, let's make it a little bit more interesting. What did you say? How much would it cost for you to eat a little piece of dog shit? I couldn't do it. Somebody started it. Give it up, everybody. Come on, there's more for you than that.
A million thank yous, man.
First person that True TV didn't want that to air.
So here's a video.
So, Sal says, how much more for you to eat a little piece of dog shit? So let's see what happens.
Here we go.
$90.
Imagine the guys that come out of the that will just eat all the dumb shit.
What do we do now? We're going to see each other. We're not very eating shit.
He's pretty shit.
No!
There's no way you do this.
I was getting a view. It's a buffet. $300.
That's not a piece of shit.
It is not. It's not right.
Oh my god!
Eat that fucking shit, buddy.
Yeah!
Thank you.